December 30, 2021. Daily Devotions.
I fix my eyes on you, the founder and the finisher of our faith. I fix my eyes on you, the solace in your suffering is my strength. And my heart is weary and my soul is weak, when it seems I can traverse the trail before me. I survey the glory of your agony, and I find the will to fight for what's before me. 'Cause you ran the race, endure it for your glory. I fix my eyes on you, the founder and the finisher of our faith. I fix my eyes on you, the solace in your suffering is my strength. As I fight to follow, you're my righteous guide, and you train me to delight in all that's holy. Heal my broken body, cure my crooked stride, throw off every weight and sin that clings so closely. I will run the race, endure it for your glory. I fix my eyes on you, the founder and the finisher of our faith. I fix my eyes on you, the solace in your suffering is my strength. I fix my eyes on you, the founder and the finisher of our faith. I fix my eyes on you, the solace in your suffering is my strength.
Matthew chapter 7, verses 13 to 14. Enter through the narrow gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the road that leads to destruction, and many enter through it. But small is the gate and narrow the road that leads to life, and only a few find it. Stand up for the truth. A teacher once challenged his fifth grade students with a simple math problem. All multiples of 5 are divisible by 10. True or false? He asked those who would answer true to stand up. Everyone in the class stood up. Perhaps they didn't understand the question or weren't paying attention. While everyone was standing, the math teacher told them with a smile, "The answer is false." Upon hearing this, the students laughed at themselves and at each other because of their mistake. After they sat down, the teacher asked them another question. All multiples of 10 are divisible by 5. True or false? This time, the students didn't want to make the same mistake. So when the teacher said that those who would answer true should stand, everyone stayed in their seats. Everyone, except for one student at the back of the classroom. The other students turned their heads, and when they saw the student standing alone, they all burst into laughter. They thought he was making the same mistake they made the first time because he wasn't paying attention. As they were laughing at him, he kept standing. They started calling him derogatory names. He still kept standing. Some more compassionate students tried talking to him from their seats. They asked him to sit down because he was making a fool of himself. But he kept standing. Then the teacher approached him and asked, "Are you sure about your answer?" He nodded and kept standing. After this, the teacher addressed the entire class again with a smile and said, "The answer is true." The students gasped in unison. The standing student whom they were laughing at was right all along. This is a true story that happened many years ago. In case you haven't guessed it yet, the standing student was me. I wish I could say that I was courageous, standing up for what I believed was right. But to be honest, I wasn't. My knees were shaking throughout. Everything in me wanted to just sit down and join the crowd. The only thing that kept me standing was the fact that I couldn't deny the truth of the simple math I was doing in my head. 10 is divisible by 5, 20 is divisible by 5, 30 is divisible by 5, so is 40, 50, 60, 70. Truth is no respecter of opinions. This is a tough reality to embrace for many of us, not just because certainty and knowledge are hard to come by, but also because we are relational beings. We want other people to like us. Nobody wants to be that guy who stands alone while everyone else is sitting down laughing at them. However, regardless of how we feel about it, truth is truth, even when everyone else says otherwise. If we depend on the world to inform all our judgments in life, we will fall together with them. Jesus warns us against this in today's passage. He said, "The gate is wide, and the way is easy that leads to destruction, and those who enter by it are many." According to Jesus, the way of the crowd is a way to destruction. The way to life is a path that only a few will take. Jesus Christ had it far, worse than any of us would. He was all alone, hanging on that cross. His friends abandoned him, and his enemies were mocking him. He even prayed to his Father, my God, why have you forsaken me?" And yet, he endured the pain and shame of carrying the sin of the world. He did it for righteousness' sake, in obedience to his Father. Through his atoning death on that cross, he brought forgiveness and salvation to his people. If we are true recipients of his immeasurable grace and kindness, we must respond to him in faith, even when the world tells us otherwise. We must stand up for truth. We must stand up for Jesus Christ because he stood up alone on our behalf. Reflection. The Bible teaches us the important values of family, community, humility, and charity. These values are important because we are finite creatures. None of us are all-knowing. Hence, we all need each other. We will encounter many situations in life when the crowd is right and the individual is apparently wrong. However, today's passage reminds us that we must be careful not to be swayed by the ways of the world. On Judgment Day, the world will not stand before God on our behalf. But if we depend on Christ and stand up for Him, He will stand up for us on that day. So, as Christians, how do we balance our calling to stand firm in Christ while being charitable and open to our unbelieving neighbors? Prayer. Thank you, Father, for giving us Jesus Christ to illuminate our hearts and minds. Jesus, you've said in your word that if we've seen you, we've seen the Father. Help us fix our eyes on you throughout our lives so that we can walk that path of righteousness that leads to life. Holy Spirit, we are weak creatures dependent on your enabling power. Fill our hearts so that we may honor you every day and live lives worthy of the gospel of Christ. In Jesus' name. Amen.